Congratulations on your new corporation. Well, you have your corporate binder. And the corporate binder is very important. Why? Because it holds all of your corporate records. Your corporate records are part of what proves what you do. What you do and why you do. When you have your minutes, when you have your resolutions, when you have to dig out those copies of your bylaws, you want to be able to get to everything right away. And the corporate binder is a great way to keep everything in one place. So we've made it easy for you. Your corporate binder has your name embossed on the side, and in the front, it tells you that it's holding all those important corporate records. So now let's get started. The first thing you'll see will be your embosser. Your embosser is like the signature of your corporation. You can emboss things to authenticate, to verify, to endorse. Those are the types of things that your embosser can be used for. You see, in times of old, when there were kings and queens and they had their insignias on their rings, they would have that piece of wax on that envelope and they would seal it. That way you knew it came from them. Only they had that special seal. Well, your corporate seal is the same way. It has on it the name of your corporation, the date that you were incorporated, and the state that you were incorporated. That makes it your official corporate seal. Now, you might wonder, when will I use it? Well, you can definitely endorse your minutes and your different documents and resolutions along the way. But there might even be different agencies and people that you might get into relationship with that would want to see your corporate seal. Maybe at the end of a contract, maybe in lieu of them identifying that your business is actually operating properly. Some brokerage accounts ask for seal specimens. So you'll see along the way that the corporate seal is important to have handy. So make sure you always know where it is. So inside of your binder, there are tabs, and all the tabs separate all the different areas that you'll have to keep record of. Well, the first tab that we have is your articles. The articles are all of your organizing instruments that come from the Secretary of State. So whether you were incorporated in Nevada or California, it would all be in this section, your articles. So the first thing you'll see behind your article section would be a cover page. The cover page is officially from the Secretary of State, and on it, it authenticates that your articles are endorsed and filed. So your articles will always have that cover page. The next sheet we see is your articles of incorporation. Those are the original articles that were filed with the Secretary of State that have an endorsed file copy stamp on it. And your copy will have a corporate ID number. The corporate ID number identifies that you are a separate entity that is certified to do business in the state. So the articles are important, and it's important to always know where they are. A lot of times when you'll do business and you'll get into different contracts, they'll ask you for a copy of your articles. So you'll want to be able to identify them right away. So this is what they would be asking for. This is what they might want to see. This is what you want to have handy, your articles of incorporation. So it's in a safe place in your binder. Your next tab is bylaws. Bylaws are the laws that govern your corporation. You see, your corporation has to be governed. It has rules and regulations, just like any other type of entity that exists. So your corporation isn't exempt from having laws that govern it. So you'll see in the next page, we have your bylaws index. That's a breakout of all of the sections that are within your bylaws. You might want to know how to remove someone, how to add someone. What happens if someone resigns? How many meetings do we have to have? Well, you can go right to that section in your bylaws on the respective page, and you'll be able to execute whatever that is. So let's get started and get into those bylaws. Now, don't be intimidated. I know that it looks like a lot of legal jargon, but you want to know that it's part of what protects you, and it's part of what allows you to do business properly. When we chose these particular bylaws for our clients as a sample, we looked to choose the ones that were going to benefit you the most, give you the most freedom, and hopefully never have the need to amend. So the bylaws would have your corporation name on it, and you'll see your Article 1. So your Article 1, which denotes that you have to have an office, will say the principal office of the corporation shall be located at 1234, your address, street, city, state, and zip code. But what we've done is we've added this clause. It says, and it may be changed from time to time by the board of directors. What that clause did was it gave you a little bit more freedom. It allows you to change. It doesn't say that your office is located there forever, and if you ever change it, you have to amend it. No, it may change from time to time. By who? The board of directors. So if the board decides to move the office to Hawaii, that's okay, because the board saw fit to change it. The corporation may also maintain offices at such other places within or without the United States as the board of directors may from time to time determine. Well, what that's done is given you the freedom to have offices outside of the United States. So if you decide to have a board meeting in Jamaica, well, that's up to you. And if the board of directors decide to do it, then that is absolutely fine. So the bylaws gives you the freedom to do the things that you need to do to run your business. So the bylaws read in such a way so that throughout you'll see where it says what it needs to say, but then gives you a little bit more freedom as to how you can execute. The other thing in your bylaws you want to make sure that you do is don't forget to sign them. It makes it official. It makes it that it is now in full of force. So if you don't sign it, then it actually isn't being implemented in your business. But you don't want to have an empty binder that's not brought to life. So the moment that you put your signature on there, it's brought to life. So that is your bylaws.